Music I like to play so well is basically the kind of music that is threatened by extinction, and not the kind of music you can go to a conservatory and learn, or learn from the printed page, but simply by being there and actually playing it. It's sort of like learning to play a bagpipe. You have to be around a bunch of bagpipers, or learning to play an accordion helps when you're around a bunch of other people that play accordions. And it's the same sort of way with certain types of music. If you're playing with in a pit in a burlesque house, you're going to establish a style, a rhythmic style that goes along with the movements of the dancers. And the old school of burlesque did provide some opportunities for certain rhythms, indigenous rhythms, that would be not heard probably anywhere else other than perhaps vaudeville or for a magic show or in the circus. There was a certain twilight world where you might hear these rhythms, but you certainly wouldn't hear them in legitimate music. So rhythms that would be conducive to essentially sensuality, things that would be shots, tom-toms, and that sort of thing. And drums now and drummers are not employed in that manner. And the theory is that the louder, the faster you play, and the more frenetic the music is, the better it is. And in those days, it was sort of like sex. Sometimes the slower, the more ponderous, or the more drawn out, or more emotionally charged it was not necessarily faster and louder. It was, as Mae West used to say, I like a man who takes his time. And burlesque dancers, especially doing exotic routines, really built the pressure up, not by a lot of fast, frenetic, linear drumming, or a lot of caterwauling, or a lot of frenetic musical line or form, but actually by creating a mood that was almost a reflection of the kundalini, or the sex urge in everyone, the build-up and the climax. And through these rhythms and these instruments, and I say instruments, and I don't take that lightly, I mean by instruments things like tom-toms that had actually bottoms as well as tops, snare drums that had snares that were tight that could be thrown off, and rim shots and things that were almost turning these instruments into living creatures that almost amplified or resonated the dancers' movements. And playing the organ for these kind of performances, usually a Hammond organ, I could sort of become as one with the dancer and the drummer and the sax man or the trumpet man or whatever, and work in a sort of almost orgiastic ensemble.
Could I hear some of the chain dragger stuff?
Yeah, we're a good example would be
you
Sort of an example of old chain dragger bump and grind music. And as you can see, it's not linear. It doesn't have a sort of jackhammer beat. It allows for incredible interpretation on the part of the dancer. A dancer has to really dance, not just dance, but move and do other things sort of on stage that are better imagined than described.
Amazing.
That is.
Amazing.
That is.
Isn't that the best?